Hey folks, Silveus here. After my inglorious and crushing defeat on the Kestrel, to a random event, after getting just, you know, bashed around by not being able to find the store and everything else going wrong, I figured I would, you know, go back to FTL, play the ship that I've been wanting to play for a while, the Cerenkov. The ship's kind of hard. Case in point, actually, I just started this recording like 5 minutes ago and then died in the first encounter. So, you know, you know how it is. No, not paying your toll. But the fact that you have an ion weapon is fantastic. Big burst of flak. Glad I missed that. Or dodged that, I mean to say. Thanks. Well, there goes my Zoltan shield. Now, it'd be cool if my drone could hit, like, just pretend to hit one of the rooms that would be relevant to my situation, you know? Like the weapons room, the shield room. Any of those, really. Or I could just keep hitting, like, you know. Thank God. Come on, just kill it. Just kill it. Please, for the love of God, just kill it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. When I gotta sit here and wait for my oxygen systems to get refilled. On the side note, unlike the last time I tried to start this recording, I didn't die right off the bat, so I mean, that's great. I also managed to surprisingly not take any damage. Now, one second here. Sorry, I had to go walk over to the side of my room and grab a Powerade. Strawberry lemonade flavored. Which I forgot to put in the refrigerator. So it's not cold right now. For some reason, having a refrigerator in my room is something that I just cannot figure out how to, like, utilize correctly. I just consistently forget to put things inside of it. It's kind of sad. But it's whatever. Wrecked Mantis Aggressor. You detect a small military outpost and a few freighters nearby. This mineral-rich planet is in an isolated location and would be perfect for an illegal Mantis mining operation. As you consider your options, a ship launches from the outpost. Prepare to fight. That is a scary amount of missile weaponry. Luckily, that's what the Zoltan shield is for. You know, that was sort of amazing. Like, that was legitimately kind of amazing. I mean, I'm not exactly thrilled about the fact that I'm about to eat it here. On the upside, they've been kind enough to run out of they've been kind enough to run out of missiles after they beat my face in, which is, you know, always nice. All right. No, don't. I didn't mean to click that. The cool if I could somehow do this without powering up my engines. You think I could pull that off? Also, Joshua... Alright. And I didn't get enough scrap to be able to... I didn't get enough scrap to be able to upgrade my my reactor, which is kind of what I was hoping to do. You know, the starting weapons and the whole like layout of this ship is just unfortunate. Nope. I need to let my oxygen refill. Because, you know, in each fight, I need to depower my oxygen system for so long. I need to give it time to refill. Luckily, that's where I drank the Powerade. I used to get Powerade all the time at school. They used to have to go from my middle school back to my house, I needed to walk past the school's, like, stadium. So, well, I'll continue the story once I figure out what's gonna kick my face in. Good. Alright. Anyway, so yeah, to get home, I had to walk past my school's, like, football stadium. We had, you know, like, big bleachers, lights, and all that jazz. And there was also, like, baseball fields, so there was, vending machines outside. So I would, very often I would get, I'd grab a thing of Powerade before I... Hey, I might as well get repairs. I'll buy space rations too while we're at it. I guess I should hold on to that. Quality heavy laser. Holy crap on a stick am I buying the crap out of... I don't have the money for that. I still don't have the money for that. That's awesome. No, I need to go back and get that. Like, I need that. I need to not encounter this, too, while we're at it. Oh, man. That moment of me not thinking straight may have just made this a loss for me, which is kind of awesome. No, I mean, it's definitely not awesome, actually. By the way, no part of this is awesome. This is actually just a disaster. It's like I can just see myself losing in real time, you know? It's kind of cool, to a certain extent, like... Look, I'm gonna die here. I'm gonna die here! Yo, this game is a joke. It's a joke. Good. So, I still don't have the weapon. I'm short a weapon. Alright, you know, let's just restart, because this is not gonna get us anywhere. That was me screwing up, which was awesome, but, you know, like, I hate this game. I really hate this game. Can I even kill this? Like, is this even something that I can actually fight? You know, I'm not even gonna try. I'm just gonna restart. Yeah, You know, it's funny. I say in my videos that you should check me out on Patreon a lot because I write some like additional commentary there. I'd like to comment on the commentary that I write. Because I'll come back to my little story with the power in a second. But I'd like to comment is like one of the things that I wrote about was how you know, I play video games because to me they're a form of, you know, an entertainment and something that I can do for fun. Yeah, I'm not too concerned about that. So, to me, you know, like, I play video games so, you know, I can have fun, obviously. I think that's how most people, or the reason why most people would play video games. Joy. But I've noticed that a lot of times I'm playing a game, and, like, FTL is kind of a good example of it, but, there are definitely other games that I have the same issue with, where, while I'm playing it, I'm not necessarily, like, having an exciting, fun time. I'm experiencing, like, a contentment, like, a feeling of, like, everything is going the way it should be. You know, everything's in its place, everything's in its, you know, is working the way I want it to be, and it's working to my expectations. And that's how I feel like with FTL. Like, when I encounter an enemy ship, my expectations are to defeat it. I'm not expecting to lose. So as I fight the enemy ship and it gets destroyed, I'm like, yeah, as expected, the enemy ship was killed. I'm not being like, yeah, woo, I overcame the odds. Like, it was a sporting event, for instance. Like, in a sporting event, when it's a match between two teams, or even like a competitive multiplayer game or something like that, It's up to debate whether or not you'll win, but I'm always expecting to win in a video game. So when I do win, I'm just like, that was what I expected to have happen. Oh boy. Are they all the same amount of money? We'll make the solar panels. So I mentioned this because, you know, oh, fantastic. Luckily, this doesn't really affect my ship all that much. Considering, you know, I have no power in the first place. I don't know, additional power to engines. Yeah, trying to run away? Oh man, that's kind of tough. Like, 6 fuel is really good. 6 fuel? Yeah, I gotta take the 6 fuel. I mean, 6 fuel is 6 fuel. Anyway, so, I feel just, instead of, like, a sense of joy and success in my success, I feel like, you know, it was like I put my pants on correctly. I'm not expecting to fail at putting my pants on correctly. When I get up and go to get changed, I have no real concern that I'm going to somehow end up choking, on fire, upside down, with pants wrapped around my head. I know they're going to be on my legs and things are going to go right. And when they don't go right for some reason, I'm, you know, shocked and appalled and angry or upset or something or freaked out, you know, something along those lines. So when I'm playing a game like this, I'm expecting to win, and when I do win, I'm just like, yeah, okay. And then when I don't win, or when anything goes wrong, I just get angry because that's something that's not working the way that it was supposed to. You know, if I had to guess, I was gonna say that there was probably like, you know, a 1,000,000% chance that was gonna happen. You know, once I saw the ion fire before the beam fired, I was like, you know, I know this is gonna suck. Although, actually, it's very interesting that they can't get... I didn't realize that the ion weapons can't overload them. That's an interesting fact. Also, definitely one that I wish I had known about in advance. Although, if that ion... You know? It's like... I hate everybody. Yeah, just kill them, please. Just kill them. Like, for real. So anyway, long story short. When I do get into these situations, I don't feel like, you know, good about myself or anything along those lines. I just feel like, you know, I put my pants on successfully. And then when I fail, for some reason, I just feel anger. Or, like, sadness. I'm just like, oh my god. Here we go again. Anyway, the Powerade thing. I used to ride my bike to school. I don't think anybody really does that anymore. Like, I don't think, and I rode my bike, like, a decent distance. I think it was, like, let's see, hold on. It was, like, 5-6 blocks? It was uphill, too. Luckily, though, the uphill part was, you know, in the morning when it was usually cooler. So then it was downhill during the afternoon when it was usually a little bit warmer. But, yeah, so I usually, you know, I'd be riding my bike back, I'd stop at the thing, get a Powerade. So I bring this up to actually tell two funny stories. One of them's actually kind of probably sad and depressing, depending on your outlook on life, but... it is what it is. So let me sell my solar panels. Swag Defense 3. Heavy anti-ship ion. Tactical combat... no. And no, and no, and no. Cloaking, artillery. Oh, snap, crackle, and pop. Gotta get the Zoltan. My friends, you always get the Zoltan. Now, I would have liked to also have picked up a human, but it wasn't to be. So anyway, let's tell the kind of sad story first. So I had this guy, a friend, that, the stress beacon is coming from a small civilian station. They have been raided repeatedly by ships coming from a nearby pirate stronghold and actually hope for rebels to come and save them. Okay, normally I would go fight them in the asteroid belt, but, I do not want to be in an asteroid belt right now. Oh no, I don't. You go over there. Well, good job not dodging anyone. Dodge? Nope. These pirates have a disappointing set of weaponry, though. Alright. Dodge? No dodge. That was unnecessary, which is unfortunate. Anyway. So I had this friend, I met him in, what was it, 5th grade, I believe? His name was Brendan. And actually, interesting fact is, I had known of him. That's too bad. They're all homeless, whatever. You know, I don't care. So I'd actually known of Brendan beforehand, from elementary school, because he went to the same elementary school as me. And he and another kid, whose name was... Patrick. No relation to SpongeBob. Were both, diabetic. And this was before, you know, everybody had diabetes from overeating, just for the record. So, they did, like, a presentation thing to kind of explain their diabetes, I guess. I don't, you know, I really don't know. Anyway, so everybody knew these two as the diabetic kids. Which, maybe wasn't the greatest thing for the school to kind of make everybody know them as, but whatever. Good. Wasted jump. I didn't even get an opportunity to talk to my crew. So anyway, so I knew of Brendan, no. We ended up, becoming, like, friends. In, I guess it was 5th or 6th grade. I honestly can't remember. So we stayed friends for a pretty, Well, I guess from, let's say I think it was fifth grade. I want to stick to fifth grade as the time we became friends. So I believe we stayed friends until about seventh. At the time, I had another friend, who I'm still actually friends with. And I knew another person whose name was Chris. Now, my friend Brendan had a weird relationship of sorts with his diabetes, in that he was very vocal about it and, like, loved talking about his diabetes. But I guess as a, like, you know, 12-year-old, 12 is 6th grade, maybe? Whatever age he was, as a kid, he consistently was not taking care of his diabetes. And he had, like, super diabetes. The sort that was like, if you were like, hey, Brendan, you want to eat a chocolate bar? He would just die. Like, he would just go into shock and die. So his mom was constantly like, you know, Brendan, you check your blood sugar? And the answer was always like, no, he didn't check his blood sugar because he was constantly forgetting. Well, sometimes it was, like, kind of annoying because she would, like, do that while all of us were there, like, hanging out, and she would do it in front of us. So it's just, like, it was a weird, like, situation with her. So the one day where it was all four of us, me, Brendan, my friend, and then this other guy who wasn't really my friend. He was a friend. I don't want to give out a lot of the names. So my friend was A, and his friend was B, and I didn't really like B all that much. B was kind of a horrible person. Let's go with that. Boop. Nice. So anyway, his mom hangs out a second floor window of their house as we've already walked down a block after, you know, meeting up at his house. She hangs out the window and she's like, Brendan, did you put your bike back? Because he was also doing stuff like that. It's like, no. Good. I was kind of hoping I would get the AI drone because I could really use getting Joshua out of the pod scene, but not to be. Well, slightly annoying. There we go. So, you know, Brendan has to go back to put his bike away and stuff like that. And, you know, now we're all just waiting there. We already walked all the way down the block. So now he's got to walk all the way back. We're waiting for him at the corner of the road. It's summertime. It's hot. It's annoying that we're being inconvenienced like this. You know, like, sure, he could have just put his bike back, but does it really matter? Like, that he left it in the backyard instead of the porch, like... Yeah, I know she wants to, like, teach her kid to be, like, mature and responsible and all that crap, but, like... It's embarrassing when you're called out like that in front of your friends, for one. And for two, she's inconveniencing, like, the rest of us, you know? Like, we had plans to go somewhere. I don't know. It's not that big of a deal. So, I was like, as he was going back, I was like, you know... His mom can be kind of a neck. So everybody's like, oh yeah, man, I know exactly what you're talking about. So he comes back after putting his bike back. And then B, who I didn't really like all that much, is like, yo, Brendan, Silveus said your mom is like a scumbag hoe, and if he ever had the chance, he would beat her to death with a shovel. And I'm like, what? No, I didn't. And then my friend A is like, what? What are you talking about? That didn't happen. So we're both like, B, what the heck are you talking about? And then Brendan is like, how dare you talk about my mom like that? So, you know, he buys it immediately and is like, you can't talk bad about my mom. So I'm like, dude, I didn't say that about your mom. She's like, well, what did you say about my mom? I'm like, dude, man, all I said was that, like, sometimes she can kind of harp on you a lot. He's like, so you were talking bad about my mom. I'm like, no, I was just saying, like, And meanwhile, B's sitting there. He's like, dude, I told you he hates your mom. I'm like, dude, I don't hate your mom. So, Brendan gets, like, super angry and actually takes a swing at me. Now, I mean, you know, we're, like, 12, so it's not a real swing or anything like that. Oh, that's fantastic right there. I'm gonna have to eye on his drone control and his shields. Meanwhile, I'm not dodging any of his shots, which is always a joy. See what part of my ship gets to eat the dude. I can't. Oh, great. If there was like absolutely a part of my ship that would be fantastic to get shot right now, it was without a doubt my pilot seat. I'm just gonna let him destroy that. I mean, what am I gonna do? Besides, miss all my shots. Dude, you know what? This game is such bullcrap! No, don't get out of there! What? Can you just put the fire out? How hard is it? I hate this game! I mean, I would have liked to take that event to, you know, do something productive, but if I tried, my ship would be dead right now. Yo, I really hate this game sometimes. Like, it's a joke. Well, anyway, God, I hate this game. This is the thing I was talking about at the beginning, right? Like, all the battles where I took only, like, minor damage and things went successfully, I have no real sense of, like, achievement over those. But lose half of my hull points and almost have all of my people die in one encounter and then be forced to skip another one? Yeah. Now I'm ticked off. Anyway, so Brendan all flipped out. How dare you talk about my mom like that? Tries to hit me. We, like, you know, push each other. We go our separate ways. I don't really talk to Brendan again, like, for a long period of time after that. And I was kind of, like, ticked off, you know, because for no real reason, B was just like, yo, I'm going to be a giant jackwad and throw a wrench into your guys' relationship. Produce something on board. Produce solar panels again. So, you know, for the longest time, I didn't ever talk to that guy again. Get him out of there, get him in there. I mean, there's gonna be casualties pretty much regardless at this point. Who's the new dude? Strom is weapons. I would prefer weapons to not die. But everybody else can die, I don't care. Alright. Oh, he died anyway. Whatever. You know, I don't care. Well, as I wait for my people to come back alive, I might as well continue my story. So, you know, I always, like, felt bad, though, that the relationship between me and Brendan, like, fell apart in that manner, because it was totally unnecessary for it to go that way. So, you know, I was all trying to be like, you know, let's hang out again and stuff like that. So I used my friend A as like an intermediary. But Brendan never really like forgave me for the whole thing that B brought up. He was always still like upset about it, and every time we would hang out, he'd be like kind of confrontational with me. So it's, you know, it's like whatever. So anyway though, like the one of the last times we were kind of going back to the we were walking around the school area to the stadium to get, you know, Powerade, because it was a Powerade is, I think, relatively low sugar. Or maybe not. No, that was right. It was that he couldn't drink Powerade, but he really liked tasting it, so he would always like, great. Want to go drink Powerade? Oh, even better. Great. Absolutely great. No. Repair faster. Good. Oh, Jesus. Thank you, God. Yo, if, like, a whole bunch of my crew just dies because of this, I'm gonna flip out. They are absolutely going to die. Two boarding events with full teams in a row. In a row. I just want to finish my story real quick because I hate this game. Anyway, so we're going to the school, and Brendan at some point picks up a 2x4 piece of wood with two rusty bent nails sticking out of the bottom of it. And he keeps like twirling it around, kind of close to me. And I'm kind of, you know, like most people, I don't appreciate rusty pieces of metal piercing into my flesh. So I'm kind of like irritated that he keeps doing it. I keep being like, yo, Brendan, keep that crap away from me, man. Yo, Brendan, get that away from me. And he keeps, like, mocking me for being afraid of it, right? So he's like, dude, Silveus, what are you scared about? I'm like, dude, it's rusty nails. I don't want tetanus. So finally, we walk by, like, a big, you know, school trash can, and he throws it into the trash can. And I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna get it out of that trash can. I'm gonna twirl it around his head and see how he likes it. So, now keep in mind, right, we're at the stadium. And, like, sports clubs are out there, and, you know, people are still, like, in the parking lot and stuff like that. So I reach into the trash can to get the rusty nail board. And then Brendan is like, yo, everybody! Silveus is digging through the trash! He screams it, so everybody's like looking at me. So I'm like, sorry, Brendan, I thought I saw your mom in there. Never mind. And then he tried to hit me again. And then we never spoke again. Alright, folks, I'm ending this recording, and then I'm gonna start another one, because I want to be successful!